We tried to dress up for you guys. We appreciate you being here.
Thank you for having us.
We'd like to start this off by introducing Michael Vick here to you. And Michael just signed a beautiful contract to hang with the Philadelphia Eagles in the city of Philadelphia for the next few years. And we can't be happier as an organization. I tribute Joe Banner for the great job he did, and Joel for the great job in representing Michael and the job that he did there. We are very excited with this signing, and with that, I'm going to turn it over to Michael.
Thank you. First off, I just want to thank God for the opportunity that I've been presented. Thank all the people in my life over the last 2 years who have made it a great contribution and a sacrifice, and you know, trying to steer me in the right direction and help me out, and it certainly paid dividends. I always lent it an open ear. Always wanted to commit myself to change. You know, especially in the last 2 years, and I was able to do that. And I think it's led to this point, to where I'm at in my life. You know, being a happy man first. And you know, as well as a you know, satisfied football player, so I'm honored to be in the position that I'm in now. I want to thank the Philadelphia Eagles organization, Jeff Lurie, you know, Howie Roseman, from you know, everybody who you know gave me the opportunity to you know be a Joe Banner. Andy Reid, thank you, Coach. I want to say that personally. You know, Roger Goodell, Tony Dungy, my agent, Joel Siegel, my family, you know, everybody who has been there for me over the last 2 years and really believed in me. And, you know, that lineage that I just named was with the group, and to this day, they've still been a major asset in my life and my everyday thinking, and you know, just treat me as a man, you know, not telling me what I want to hear, but telling me what I need to hear. And I think that's made a great contribution into my life and to my way of thinking. And like I said, I think that's the reason I'm here now. The reason I got this opportunity, and the reason I'm gonna make the most of it. So, to all those people that I just named, if I left anybody out, I'm sorry, but that group right there is the main reason that I'm here. You know, I'm glad to be a part of a great organization, ready to lend you know, all my support. You know, prepare myself and make the greatest contribution to this game that I can make. And just, you know, go back in time and think about, you know, how hard it's been over the last 2 years, but the sacrifices that I had to make and what I had to give up, and it's been all worth it. So with that said, you know, like I said, once again, I just want to thank this organization for the opportunity. And, you know, the common goal is to, you know, bring that ring back to the city of Philadelphia, and, you know, that's what we're working towards. So, you know, I want to thank you all, and I've enjoyed every minute that we spent together, and I look forward to spending the next 6 years with you all. So, thank you.
We'll open up the questions to Michael and Andy. Mike, do you ever take a moment to just kind of reflect on how far you've come personally in these last 25 months?
I do it on, you know, not on a daily basis, but, you know, it's always something that's going to be a part of me. It's the reason why I work so hard each and every day. And it's the reason I come to work dedicated to become the best that I can be. And, you know, nothing's going to come easy in life. And I've learned a lot of lessons, you know, some the hard way. some just, you know, standard procedure, but, you know, I think, you know, just the things that I've been through has helped, you know, mold me into the person that I am and you know, what I can foresee in my future. And that's continue to do the same things that I've been doing and, you know, enjoying life and doing things the right way.
Mike, was there ever a moment where you thought maybe this wasn't going to ever happen?
I mean, absolutely. I think, you know, like I said, you know, sometimes, you know, as a man, you feel what you can't see. And, you know, nobody can predict the future. You don't know what's going to happen. Tomorrow's not promised. But the only thing you can do is, you know, just live your life and hope for the best. Continue to have faith and believe in yourself. And, you know, the thing for me was believing in the people that, you know, was there for me in time of need. And, you know, this organization was there for me. My agent has always stuck by me, Joel Siegel. Like I said, another guy who, you know, always was a person who didn't tell me what I wanted to hear, tell me what I needed to hear. And, you know, just, you know, was there for me when I needed. So, you know, you never know what's going to happen. But, you know, you expect the best, hope for the worst. I mean, expect the worst, hope for the best, and you know, that's what I did. But, you know, God was on my side, and I'm here today.
Mike, are there any plans, you know, with that, to make donations to charity in light of your past with the Humane Society or wherever else?
Those are things that I've been doing, dedicating my time. You know, I don't necessarily think it's all about the money. But, you know, at a time of need, that will happen. But I'm just glad that all the people, you know, who gave me an opportunity to even work with the Humane Society, and Wayne Pasetti was one of them. So, you know, there's a lot of people that was in my life over the last 2 years that was very influential and helped me get to this point where I'm at today.
Can you talk about Tony Dungy and how much he's helped?
Coach Dungy was another guy that I named who was very influential in the process of helping me get back into the NFL. You know, continued to give me proper advice on a weekly basis, sometimes monthly basis. And, you know, a guy I have a lot of respect for. And everybody that I just named, I have a lot of respect for. And they're the reason, you know, why I strive so hard and thrive so hard to become the best, not only on the field, but off the field. So, you know, it's another guy, another person who I have the utmost respect for and don't want to let down.
Mike, talk about how hard you've worked in the last 2 years to kind of get everything back that you've lost. Since you now have gotten all that back, do you fear that maybe you'll lose that edge because you've gotten everything pretty much that you've lost?
Absolutely not. I think if anything, it makes me want to work harder. You know, just to continue to show that, you know, I'm worthy of everything that I'm getting. I think back to when I first got here and the commitment that I made to myself and to Andy. And that won't change. And I've always been a guy who worked hard. And I've seen the progress that's been made in my career. And why stop? You know, so it's something that drives you and motivates you. And you know, I'm motivated now because, you know, I play with such great teammates, and we have an opportunity to do something special. And, you know, I could be on the stage right now with all my teammates and what they've done for me and, you know, the sacrifices that they've made for me, you know, last year. And, you know, I just have to give those guys credit as well because none of this would be possible. And we all know how hard it is to reach certain levels. But, you know, through teamwork, you make dream work, and, you know, that's what we've been able to do.
Mike, this contract puts you in an elite level with Peyton Manning and Tom Brady and those guys who've won Super Bowls. Does that now become really the only thing that matters? I mean, do you feel like you have to win a Super Bowl in these 6 years to kind of validate this?
Absolutely. I mean, you play this game to better your craft, to better yourself, you know, as a football player. And, you know, like I said, that one common goal is winning the Super Bowl. And that's why we play. And, you know, as a competitor, I don't feel like my career would be complete without that. And, you know, that's the reason I work so hard. And I have to give a lot of credit to Andy because, you know, every day he's coaching me up. There's always something new. And I know I never get to a point where I know it all, but he can certainly help me get there 90% of the way. And you know, that's why I'm appreciative of where I'm at and sitting right here before you and having a chance to be with this team for another 6 years.
Andy, do you remember what point during this timeline might change from a great story to one where you wanted to hand the keys to him for the next 6 years like you just did?
Well, listen, I mean, you know, this is a great story all the way through, and this is really what America is all about, second chance, you know, and Mike took full advantage of that, and then when he was given a second chance and having an opportunity to start in a National Football League, he took again an opportunity there and turned it into this. So I would tell you at that time, when he got himself back physically, ready to play, I think everybody on the football field and in the stadium knew that he was back. And I don't think it was too hard to see.
Mike, I was wondering if you remember anything about the day you signed the deal back in 04, Christmas Eve, and just how does this feel different than that, and how are you different?
Well, it doesn't really feel any different. You know, last time I was sitting here doing a press conference, I was signing with the Eagles, and like I said, I didn't know what direction my future was going in. All I know is I was happy to be on the football team and having a chance to play football again. And, you know, 2 years later, I'm sitting before you, have an opportunity to be Philadelphia Eagle long term. So, you know, it's a totally different subject matter, but at the same time, you know, it's a blessing. And I was, you know, ecstatic at that point 2 years ago to be sitting next to Andy, and even happier now. So, under different circumstances. So, like I said, it's just, it was all in God's plan, and I kept the faith. I thank him, and I couldn't have done it without him.
What about the first big contract that you signed with the Falcons last year? What's the difference between that and this?
There's no difference. And the contract, I mean, it's a lot of money, however you look at it. Obviously, it's going to create, you know, a lot of demands. And, you know, I know what comes along with it, and I know how to handle it. But I think, you know, aside from the money, it's not even about that. It's about, you know, the changes that's been made in my life. You know, kids have an opportunity to see that you should never count yourself out. But at the same time, don't put yourself in a position where you got to make a miraculous comeback. That's not what it's about. You know, I did it through the grace of God, and because I had the will to do it. And everybody may not have that, but, you know, I say that to say, you know, just be appreciative of what you have, you know, the opportunities you've been given in your life, and don't take anything for granted. And, you know, I did that at one point when I had the big contract in Atlanta, and I think that'll definitely help me now in understanding what's most important and how to move forward in my life. To not make those mistakes and use the advice that I'm getting correctly. So it's all a blessing.
Mike, when you first signed here, was there ever a thought that maybe this day wouldn't come?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, like I said, you never know what's going to happen. you know, you just take advantage, you just live in the moment and take advantage of the opportunities that you've been given. And, you know, but know what type of talent you have, you know what you can do, you just got to be patient. And that's something I've learned over the years, unfortunately, when I was away, but everything in life happens for a reason, and that told me patience, and I think that's part of the reason why I'm here today, being patient.
Given where you're at now, Michael, given where you're at now and what you've been through, making a lot of money with it, you said the demand has come, how do you keep pushing the brakes in terms of people asking you for money or people asking you for time or autographs or whatever? How do you do that?
Well, I think you just have to create a balance, you know, within your life. And things have to be structured a certain way within your life so that, you know, you're not making too many commitments, so you're not, you know, giving people too much, or, you know, not saying no when you need to, you know, saying no when you have to, you know, it's a balance that has to be created. And, you know, I've you know, changed so many, you know, so many facets of my life to a point where you know, that doesn't even matter anymore. You know, I spend so much time preparing to be the best quarterback that I can be. And, you know, with my kids that, you know, I don't even see that area in my life anymore. And, you know, with age comes change. And, you know, I think, you know, things happen in your life in phases and stages. And I was, you know, I had to live through that. And, you know, I did it. And, you know, it all happened for the best of me.
Do you get a sense of how of people's opinion changed of you over the last 2 years? And the second part of that, are you bothered at all that some people are stubbornly saying, I'll never change my opinion about the guy?
And I'm just trying to be the best person that I can be. You know, I can't control what, you know, what people think, their opinions or their perception. You know, I think that's personal and that's for them. But, you know, the only thing I can control is what I can control, and that's trying to be the best person I can be, you know, the best citizen I can be, the best father that I can be. And, you know, I think that speaks for itself. And, you know, that's not by force, that's by choice. So, you know, some things may never change. You know, I may never change in certain facets of my life, but, you know, it is what it is.
Mark, last year you had a spectacular year. There are a lot of people who are wondering whether or not you can duplicate that again. Maybe you thought last year was a fluke or something. Determined on you to prove that, hey, you know, that you can be that quote-unquote pocket passer and that quarterback. How determined are you to prove that you can be that complete quarterback?
I think my track record speaks for itself. I think I've been pretty consistent in this league for a long time. I don't see why anything would change. I feel like the players that I've been surrounded with, the coaches that I have, you know, Andy is by far one of the best in this league. And that just gives me confidence within itself. On top of, you know, my abilities and what I can do, we'll take full advantage of that. So I don't worry about that part. I feel like that's gonna happen. How it happens and when it happens, that's all remains to be seen. But, you know, I'm just confident in what we can do as a team, not in what I can do. You know, I mean, I'm confident what I can do to a certain extent, but what we can accomplish as a team, you know, that's what's most important. So it's not about me duplicating my performances. It is to a certain extent, but what we can do. And, you know, I'm just happy that I'm on a team that has been well put together. You know, by great management, and you know, we're taking off, so you know, we'll see.
Mike, what do you think the message or the lesson of this contract is?
Excuse me?
The message or the lesson of this contract, what is it? What do you think this contract says to people about you, about
them? I mean, I think the contract was put together because the people who wanted me to be here, you know, made an obligation to make me you know, the quarterback of the team for the next couple of years. And like I said, I'm appreciative of that. And, you know, I don't think it was done to teach any lesson or anything is going to, you know, stand behind it. You know, it was done for a reason, and it was to make me the quarterback of the Philadelphia Eagles for the next 3 years and try to win the Super Bowl.
Do you think you did take some teams by surprise or some people by surprise last year with how far you'd come all the way back, and how, you know, out of sight, out of mind a little bit? And do you think there'll be more of a bullseye on you this year in terms of teams preparing for you, and the challenge might be even greater?
Well, that's something Andy and I talk about all the time. I'm always going to have a bullseye on my back. The team's going to always try to game plan, try to figure out a way to stop me. But it's my goal, it's my job to not let that happen. And, you know, I think that's all my preparation, my dedication and my commitment to the sport and to my position, not to let that happen. So, that's never going to change. But like I said, I'm confident in what we can do as a team.
This is the first time that you've really had, 09 and last year, you didn't really know what the future held as far as whether you'd be here or somewhere else long term. You just described the feeling knowing you'll be an Eagle possibly the rest of your career for the next good chunk of your career.
But that's an outstanding feeling for me to know that, I'm going to be here possibly for the duration of my career. And, I know I can't play this game forever. I know the time, the clock is ticking. And, that's more motivation for me to try to get it done as early as I can. And, it's just another opportunity that's been created in my life to, press forward and shoot for the stars. I look at it as a challenge. And as a competitor, you love challenges. You want to be in this position. And, nothing will make me happy than to put a ring on this guy's finger right here next to me, and then mine as well. So that's my focus. That's what I'm setting out to do. And that's what I'm going to rally this team up to do.
Michael, you talked about the relief of knowing that you're here for a few more years, obviously. What about the relief financially?
You've
been some financial problems. Is there some relief there that you know that you can kind of pay off your creditors and move forward?
Absolutely. A lot of things happened in my life, whether things were done right or wrong, it doesn't matter anymore. I have an opportunity to move on with my life, and that's all I prayed for, and that opportunity has come. But it wasn't easy. It wasn't easy. It was all in the unknown, and I didn't know what was going to happen. But, it happened. So, that'll be a breath of fresh air. And like I said, I could just focus on football, but it was never something that bothered me or I was concerned about or worried about. Because I just felt like the situation was in God's hands, whether things had been done right or wrong, or it was my fault or somebody else's. It doesn't even matter. I can focus on football, like I said earlier, and focus on being the best person, the best dad that I can be, and that means more to me than anything.
Mike, I know we've
talked... Two more questions, guys.
You talked about the football part of it, but whatever you consider your low point, whenever that was, when you had time to yourself, a lot of it, did you ever think a day like this would happen again?
No. To be honest, I never thought this day would come again in my career. Like I said, I wanted a chance to play again and just to prove myself. To this magnitude, I didn't think it would happen this way. But that goes to show how much I know. Just keep pressing forward, and keep believing. I think, faith is something that we all have to have at the end of the day. I'm living proof. If you believe in yourself and commit yourself to doing certain things, you can do it. And it's all mental. It's all mental. Everything that I've been through over the last, 3 or 4 years of my life has just been a challenge mentally. And, to see how I was going to respond to it, that's how I feel. And not responding in the right way with the help of a lot of people because I couldn't have done it by myself.
Andy, when you look at the quarterback Michael's become under your watch, where does this rank in terms of your accomplishments as a coach?
Well, I think the one thing that probably has not been mentioned here is, Michael obviously is very gifted as an athlete and as a person. But the hard work that went into doing this, and this was Michael, and he's had Marty Mornowig and James Irvin and Doug Peterson now to work with. But if it wasn't his want-to and his attitude and his work ethic, that, you know, none of this was possible. So I think it's really a tribute to him more than us, and how he's come back and the effort that he's put forward for kids. And the story of this, Les, I think is just that through hard work and keeping your nose clean and doing the right things, and good things happen. And then also, there can be opportunity for a second chance, and how do you handle that second chance? I think that's really the story here. But none of this is possible without Michael being in the right frame of mind and then working his tail off on and off the field, and that's what he did. Bottom line, that's what he did. And he had a lot of, again, he mentioned all the people that were the support of it, but it really came down to his attitude on change and the attitude of the